A first-hand look at what's happening at the beach. WESH 2's Claire Mez continues our team coverage from Volusia County.
Down in New Smyrna Beach at the jetty, they're seeing rocks exposed that haven't been in years, but all along the coastline here. Take a look at what's been lost to these November storms. Significant erosion. A stiff north-northeast wind has flooded the beach at high tide and beyond. The beach, famous for driving, is off limits to motorists.
It's been like this all weekend. We've had an onshore wind for the last few days, and the beach has remained closed to driving all weekend.
Sandy took the first swipe at this coastline when she passed offshore last month, but a nor'easter blowing for days has cut deep into the dunes, washing away precious sand. Conservation poles that have to be in place before the beach can open to driving are not standing tall.
The wind's driving the water up. It's hitting the seawall. It's hitting the poles, knocking the poles down. Every day we are out there putting in about at least 100 poles.
The sea itself is volatile, with 6 to 8 foot surf that will stay big all week. And coming in so hard, the ocean washes up through beach approaches and pedestrian walkways. It gobbles up sand, litters the shore with debris. Volusia County beaches actually had some good buildup over the summer, but it looks like much of that sand will be lost because of this wicked November weather, and who knows how long this is going to last. In Daytona Beach, Volusia County, Claire Metz, WESH 2 News.